Drachenritt was the first roller coaster at Volantis, opening with the park in 2003. This was Gerstlauer's third bobsled coaster, which is the German company's take on the classic Wild Mouse coaster. You have the familiar hairpin turns, but you also have a more fleshed out layout with helixes, banked turns, and bunny hills. But is this one of the better Gerstlauer bobsleds out there? Find out in this review of Drachenritt. Gerstlauer built their first bobsled and first coaster in general at Tripstrel in 1998 with Gesenkte Sau. And Drachenritt has a lot of similarities to that ride. The layout is near identical. It has the same progression of elements, going from a drop, to hairpin turns, to a double helix, to bunny hills, and to a helix finale. And the first half has some theming as well on both rides. Drachenritt is German for dragon ride, and that's a fitting name for this coaster. It's part of Volantis' Insel der Ritter, or Knight's Island section of the park. The coaster's first half takes place around a castle, while the finale takes place over the park's central lagoon. While the coaster is a rather dull color scheme, the ride's placement and theming more than compensates. Now, the ride's queue line is bizarre. The entrance is not where you'd expect. It faces away from the attraction, in these giant hedges. It looks more like one of those hedge mazes from Roller Coaster Tycoon than a coaster entrance. But that's sort of fitting because the queue really is a maze. After winding through the hedges, you navigate this weird series of switchbacks. It's just a dirt path with some temporary fencing. It's a pretty jarring contrast to the rest of Volantis, which looks pretty nice. The next part of the queue line is this floating bridge above the park's lagoon that sways with each step. You then reach Drachenritt Island. You then follow this stone path with tall hedges on both sides, and eventually leads to the station. If the line starts in this section of the queue line, as it did for me, you'll have to wait roughly 20 minutes. Each car seats 4 riders total across 2 rows. On the day I visited, Drachenritt was running 3 cars. The station is dark and has some light medieval theming. Once dispatched, the door in front of you opens and you ascend the lift hill. The top of the lift passes through one of the castle's turrets, and then you head down a decently steep drop, which gives a tiny pop of airtime. The pullout then twists to the left and you have a terrifying head chopper as you shoot through a cutout on the castle. You then pass through a mid-course brake run that does nothing, and then you navigate a series of hairpin turns atop the castle. You get some decent laterals, but you don't have a ton of speed through this section, so they're not as extreme as some Wild Mouse coaster laterals, but the view overlooking the lagoon is beautiful. After passing through another mid-course brake run that again does not slow you down, you navigate back-to-back helixes. The first is a downwards one with some okay force to it. The second is quite dizzying as it's a more compact upwards helix that pulls some good sustained positive Gs. After another mid-course that again will not slow you down, you traverse back-to-back bunny hills. The first one offers okay floater airtime, while the second one is much better. It offers decent floater airtime, and the drop is much bigger as it dips below the pathway and below the water level. You then rise into another mid-course brake run that, again, surprise surprise, does not slow you down. You then navigate a relatively tame helix over the water, but it finishes by zooming into a dragon-themed tunnel that looks pretty decent. You then navigate one mildly forceful turn in the dark before emerging in the daylight and hopping into the brake run, ending the coaster. So what would I rate Drachenritt? I would give this Gerstlauer bobsled a 7 out of 10. This is a solid family coaster. The ride is presented well with the castle in the first half and dragon tunnel at the end. And it's decently well paced too. Despite all the brake runs, they don't slow the car down one bit, and Drachenritt does a little bit of everything. It has a decent initial drop, some enjoyable hairpin turns, good forceful helixes, and some airtime filled bunny hills. This ride is extremely smooth, and I wish some US parks bought this model because it really is a well-rounded crowd pleaser. I prefer High by Fart at Kloten and Van Helsing's Factory at Movie Park Germany, but Drachenritt is in the next group of Gerstlauer bobsleds in terms of quality. So those are my thoughts on Drachenritt, the fun family coaster at Volantis. What are your thoughts on Drachenritt? Do you enjoy Gerstlauer bobsleds? I would love to hear your thoughts on this coaster down in the comments. If you enjoyed this review, I'd appreciate if you gave this video a like, and you considered subscribing, because there'll be a lot more roller coaster and amusement park videos here at Canopy Coaster. Thanks for watching.